Damn, Iizuka. Alright, so the nation's biggest flip-floppers, Sonic Team, are back at it again with a new flip-flop. So we've got an article called The Making of Sonic Adventure. And this is new, by the way. And this website, pressreader.com, speaks to Takashi Iizuka and Kazuyuki Hoshino on the making of Sonic Adventure. Now, admittedly, this is a good read, so I recommend checking this out regardless. But we are going to be focusing on the part where Iizuka turns on the flip-flop like a fish from Big Section, I don't know, lame pun. But towards the later part of the article, it gets to a point where it says, 20 years on, plenty of fans still have fond memories of Sonic Adventure 2. But what do the creators think keeps people coming back? Hoshino believes it's because of each character's deep story, which I can agree with that. And it says Iizuka believes that it's the totality of the game rather than any individual aspect. I can agree with that because you've got all these stories intertwined that come together. It's a full adventure. It's not just Sonic running through a few hours and that's it, you know, like colors. It was the first high-speed 3D action game that also featured a scenario highlighted with six different stories, the A-Life Chow, six unique styles of gameplay. It is a unique game offering even 20 years after its release. At the time, it also wasn't just a solitary software release. It was the title to bring people to the Dreamcast, the best console. And we were given the budget to make something to showcase the hardware, says the director. Clearly proud of the team's accomplishments. However, it was the very first 3D game that we worked on, and looking at it now, I can see rough edges it has, which really makes me want to remake it again, he adds with a laugh. That comment is sure to bait the fans. And can you imagine Sonic Adventure's ambition realized with today's tech? It's a tantalizing project. Consider us on the hook too. So, Iizuka. Wow, he said that. Like, remember when the Adventure era was new and they basically fobbed off the Classic era? Like, we ain't fucking with that shit no more. Even in this article, there's a part where they're just like, we can't do 2D no more, we gotta go 3D. And admittedly, that was 98 when that happened, so obviously I understand that. But it's the way they flip-flop. Like, we ain't touching no classics. And then a boost era hits, and then it's like, we ain't touching no non-boost, we ain't touching no multiple playable characters, fuck that shit. And then Classic Sonic comes back, and it's like, we ain't touching no fully 3D games no more, we ain't touching no originality, man. It's Green Hill, Old Zones only. And now we've come full circle back to thinking about the Adventure era, making articles on the Adventure era, and we want to do a remake sometime and all these things. And you know why? It's because Sega love to do what other people are doing. In a sense that, not that they're unoriginal, I mean, recent Sonic is unoriginal, but I mean in the sense that they like to follow trends. When 3D was hot, they couldn't fathom the idea of making a 2D game. And they didn't, you know, I get it, you know, 3D was hot, I understand. You know, certain things like there being Hubworld and Adventures, because that was a cool thing to do at the time. Certain things like 06 being really realistic, because that was a cool thing to do at the time. We were moving on to 7th gen hardware when realism was the thing that everyone was striving for in graphics. It wasn't about no art style with no cell shading that didn't look real. If your shit didn't look real, you had to go home. Unless you're Nintendo, because they do whatever the fuck they want to do. So that's why 06 looks real. The Werehog being in Unleashed was because that kind of gameplay was popular at the time, and Sega wanted to emulate it. The whole premise of Sonic being created was to rival Mario. They like to do what their peers are doing. Now, I mean, there's nothing wrong with this to an extent, but when they flip-flop so hard in interviews, it hurts. Like, when they act like the Adventure era doesn't exist, and then they pull some shit like this, you're like, oh, because Crash did the remakes, and those did well. Now they're remaking Crash Team Racing. Now Spyro remakes have come out, those are doing well. All of a sudden, it's like, oh, yeah, the Adventure era, yeah, we love that. We'd love to do a remake, come on, like, the Adventure, yeah, like, but before you was like, we don't touch that fully 3D shit. We don't touch those original stages. Come on, man. Green Hill, nostalgia, 2D, classic Sonic. That's what we do. Now, Iizuka's talking about he wants to do a remake. I'm surprised they even let him put that in the interview. Unless that shit really is happening for 2019. I made a video on this, on whether we'd get Adventure Remake in 2019. And there have been some little hints before that were alluding to that. Nothing serious, but things at least to grasp on. But of course, we don't know if this is actually going to happen. And more importantly, looking at the last paragraph of this article, it says, can you imagine Sonic Adventure's ambition realized with today's tech? Let me ask you, can you imagine Sonic Adventure's ambition realized with today's Sonic team? Will they pull it off? Will they fuck it up? We don't know. And just going back to that point that Iizuka said earlier in the article, when they were basically given the budget by Sega, Sonic is the front man, we need to promote our hardware, the Dreamcast. You guys, Sonic team, are getting the budget to make the biggest shit possible. Six playable characters, let's go. And now it's kind of like they've been relegated to the backseat because the reputation of Monosonic is not as high as it used to be. You know, Sonic has had a rough transition into the third dimension, of course. So therefore, would they even get the budget to truly realize a Sonic Adventure remake the way it needs to be? Or would they just get some little budget to the side, like, yeah, do a remake, and then promote it hard and then make profits? All they'll do is make it look better than the original, because, you know, graphics is the easiest thing to upgrade for them. Probably fuck up the control, probably fuck up the voice acting, probably fuck up a bunch of other things you love about Adventure. I mean, the control is the main one. They fuck that up. But it will look pretty in the trailers, and then we'll buy it, and then we'll be like, oh, this controls like Lost World. And then the appeal of Adventure, which is abusing that control, is gonna be gone. It's gonna be like rigid and scripted and shit. Like, but let me know what you guys think. Is Iizuka flip-flopping hard? Do you not care because he's recognizing Adventure? I don't know. But that's all I have to say right now. So Remy out.